Hello and welcome to the semifinals. Kept his hand on the draw. Not much to think about. I'm beginning to think this deck should have like 11 white sources. And if I played against an aggro deck where edicting on turn 2 was important, I would definitely board up to 11. Undead Minotaur. Last game I played Scroll Thief first, and I think it might have just been wildly incorrect. Here it's definitely incorrect because my opponent has a blocker for the Scroll Thief, whereas the Griffin Sentinel can get in a point of damage. Not anymore though. Yeah, I'm just gonna eat four. Hope I draw a white source. Now that that happened, I wish I'd played Scroll Thief. Water Servant doesn't trade with this guy yet. Probably going to end up taking another 4 damage here. Oh my god. Losing to this is pretty painful as I'm sitting here with double Celestial Flare in hand. Yeah, I'll go to 9. Not playing my land yet because we're still hoping to rip a white source. And we could play Air Servant and try and triple block. But that would have ran into that Ring Flesh real bad. As is, I'm just going to play Messenger Drake and jump with it. Losing to the suit up my guy plan with a double flare in hand. No, Moto, what are you doing? It's not worth it, Moto. Can I... Moto's wigging out real bad. Alright. That worked, I guess. He might be mono black. Oh, we got a plains. Don't play another creature. That's all I ask. No, he's playing another creature. Oh no, he just played a corrupt. Yeah, I don't care. And now he has one card in hand. So we should win pretty easily from here. Celestial Flare answering his one dude. Quag Sickness, yeah, that's fine. One of the strengths of Mono Black is that it just gets to play the best removal spell in the format. Blue gets the second best. I think Claustrophobia is actually the second best removal spell. If not like Essence Scatter. Holding up Celestial Flare doesn't, like, bluff a counter or anything. But I would feel pretty silly if he, like, played a Sweet Haste guy. Yeah, that's fine. This guy is just dying to get edicted. I was thinking about sending in Mutavault to, like, bait the edict now. But not only does that kind of telegraph my hand, it also prevents him from, like, suiting up his guy. If he's playing Dark Favor and Mark, it's actually reasonable that he would have, like, another Mark of the Vampire or something to put on it. As we see. So if I attack with Mutavault, it kind of, like, telegraphs the flare, and then this is less likely. Because a 4-6 is like a reasonable threat on its own. I don't think he really had to suit up the mark. Like, he didn't need the life gain or anything. And now he's hellbent. And we drew yet another flare. So because we have the flare, I don't really want to offer the trade with my Mutavault. I think the flare is worth more. I kept a land in hand because, I don't know, Liliana Spectre. I realize that's not a card in this format, but you never know when black has some random middling discard thing. I think it's just Mind Rot. Which holding a land doesn't prevent against. But if I drew another land, then I'd be preventing the Mind Rot. And Mutavault should have came in last turn, I think. Because then I would have gotten in 2 more damage this turn. He'd be at 21. Not the end of the world, but not saying. That sort of thing doesn't matter. Two life is two life, right? Charging Griffin. It's the best kind of Griffin. No offense, Griffin Sentinel. Okay. Serving in. Got him down to 16. I like this. I like this a lot. I think he needs like a corrupt to get back into this game. That would buy him a lot of time. Just corrupt the Air Servant. Good use of Shock. Shock's a pretty high pick. According to Channel Fireballs, Owen Turtenwald. Shock's usually a high pick, though. Though there are some core sets that are slower. Like I think the faster the core set is, the better Shock becomes. Like, Shock is always good, but it's not always a first pick. He found something. Yep. He's just sending it at me? That is scary. That's gonna put me to 4. Oh my. Well, hopefully his last card isn't a Lava Axe. He might be playing to draw a third Corrupt. Jeez. Just trying to burn me out. I have him on a 2-turn clock. Banisher Priest doesn't really speed things up. Though I guess if he plays a blocker, I can just exile it. Oh, Fireball. Yep. Well, that's awkward. So, if we'd hit that plains a turn earlier, or if we'd just broken down and jumped with a charging griffin that one turn instead of dropping to 9, we would have ended up winning that game. Awkward stuff. Frost Breath seems good against him. I like Trading Post against him too. Oddly enough, I think I like Trading Post more. Trained Condor is a little weak. I like the rest of this deck a lot.